The world's first genetically modified children are a living, breathing reality. They were born in China from a completely unethical experiment that'll change future generations in ways we don't yet know or even understand, and Russia wants to keep doing it. So could it be a cure for incurable diseases, or science playing God? It all starts with CRISPR. CRISPR is a tiny bacteria that can be programmed to find a section of DNA inside a cell. It literally snips that section out and replaces it with a new one. That edit can be used on blood cells, for example, which only affects the individual, or far more controversially, it can be used on reproductive cells like eggs, sperms, or embryos, meaning any changes can be passed on to future generations. That's known as germline genome editing, and everyone from Harvard to Big Pharma is getting on board with it. The first scientist to edit embryos that became babies, though, is this guy.
Two beautiful little Chinese girls named Lulu and Elana came crying into the world as healthy as any other babies.
Those babies apparently had their DNA edited to make them resistant to HIV. It sounds like groundbreaking science, right? Well, here's why those babies shouldn't exist. CRISPR is unpredictable. At the moment, CRISPR is a bit like using Siri or Google Assistant. It sounds useful, but ask for the weather tomorrow and you might instead get sent 100 boxes of adult nappies.
It's simply too early to start using germline genome editing in human reproduction. We don't have the evidence that it's either safe, effective, or even useful for any particular condition to be able to start using it at this point.
We also don't know what the butterfly effect might be. The thing is, changing one gene to make a person less susceptible to one disease might actually make them more susceptible to another. And we might not find that out until it's too late, like generations too late. Finally, gene editing is like using a sledgehammer to crack a nut. Take the HIV-resistant CRISPR babies. HIV is both treatable and preventable using existing techniques, which are much safer than forever changing the DNA of the human race. Which might be why the scientific father of those babies is now sitting in a Chinese prison. And after that, a lot of people, even scientists, called for a temporary ban, which sounds like a good idea, right? Not quite, and here's why.
It would simply not be useful. It just wouldn't do what people would want it to do, in the sense that it wouldn't stop scientists from actually going ahead and using CRISPR.
That's because any ban would be voluntary and there's absolutely no way of policing it. So far, Australia is only one of about 30 countries that have laws to prevent CRISPR babies. And can we trust the ones that don't to act ethically? A Russian scientist has already declared he wants to produce more CRISPR babies, and there's no explicit law against it there. So whether it's Russia or one of the other 150 countries that haven't outlawed it, the trajectory is clear. Someone will eventually use this technology.
Even to have properties that we would consider maybe to be desirable, like a different eye color. Designer humans, if you will.
Designer humans sounds like some kind of scary dystopia, but the answer isn't less research, it's more. The experiments that scientists do in petri dishes will tell us if it's possible to do it safely in humans. And those experiments might even tell us to avoid it altogether. So while we shouldn't ban CRISPR research completely, the case against gene editing babies, for now at least, is pretty clear-cut.
Hey, if you enjoyed that, make sure you subscribe to The Feed's YouTube channel.
And you can watch these videos here. See you next time.